been fought with kids, can't replace it all, making the kills, shooting at anything that could.
With 100 rounds, so you know it's gonna be good.
Better stay for sale, in a place where we can't see. Grabbing that knife, it ain't even been we.
I like Lil Wayne and I like Juvenile too, but Turk and BG, love them niggas. They really gave me the, like, any kind of ambition to do any kind of, like, entertainment. Like, you know what I'm saying? Just seeing somebody so relatable just made me, you know, look at them like, damn. But it's crazy because, like, right before I came home.
It's real. Alone. Understand now, I'm a grown man now. I was out there, dog, no more dope in the veins now. I done been through it, and I know what it's like when you can't get no sleep on an all-night flight. Not worrying about shit, not a goddamn thing. All you want is that hit, and to hear that ring. I know it's hard, dog. It ain't easy to quit. When that monkey on your back, nigga, need that shit. You got to feed that bitch, cause he gon' straight blues ya. Get that noise out to you, especially if you
ain't
shooter.
Slick, nigga, you think you got away with that little paperwork, nigga. That shit ain't nothing, nigga. You get that shit every day,
but I'm just keeping it real, telling it.
2 months before I came home, I was sitting in the pod, and I really couldn't hear the TV, but I seen the hot video come on. And I just seen the way, I never seen a video like that before. Like, I don't know, you probably have, but me, I never seen nothing like that before. Like, Father's on that street, that hood, that project level. I'm like, God damn, who the hell is these dudes? You know what I'm saying? So, like, before I even recognized the talent that they had, I was feeling the atmosphere of the structure around the video. I was like, man, I gotta fuck with these niggas, and I ain't even really much heard what the fuck they got them music was like. So you know, that's when I came home, and I finally, like, you know, they was like hot at the time, so I'm looking at the XXL, you know, they up there. So as I'm reading their story, I was like, oh yeah, this is very relatable. Like, you know what I'm saying? I still much haven't heard their music yet. But like Turk, yeah, that's like my favorite right there. So it's crazy because I actually got to be with him, you know what I'm saying? Way back when, like, street nigga, like them niggas, goddamn it, they come to the city, you know what I'm saying? And he tell you in his book, they got a Martin Luther King run, and I was the happen to bump into him on the Martin Luther King run. You know what I mean? And goddamn it, send me. You know, I'm with the shit at the time, so I go back to the where I gotta go and get what I get, go back to the hotel. They out there hollering, where is that? And any street nigga know what a nigga talking about when he talking about where is that. You know a nigga ain't talking about no weed, cause you can goddamn it, you know what I'm saying? You can weed or, you know a nigga talking about where is that, you already know if you in that field, in that land, you already know what the fuck they talking about. So, you know, that was early on, you know what I'm saying? I've been rocking with that nigga HotBoy Turk since then and shit. But one of the motherfucking times when they had came back, you know what I'm saying? And I noticed my nigga was gone. Where the fuck Turk at? You know what I mean? Turk ain't there. You know what I mean? So I'm like, damn, I don't really know what's going on at the time. You know, I just know my nigga ain't there. And I know, like, a day before a preview, they was like, Turk will be here tomorrow or whatever to premiere his video. It's in me.
Come on, look. When I start to spree, clear the way, I get knocked. Cause once my thing cock, I didn't aim and pop. I'm a donkey won't leave, untamed.
106 and pop, premiere of the day or whatever, how they used to do that shit. I mean, I ran, see my nigga. I ain't never been the type of nigga who fuck a nigga or I fuck them niggas, they niggas just like me. And you know, damn, you kissing a rapper ass or you starstruck or you a group or whatever. I be honest, I don't heard all that shit, but let me explain something to you about that. When you a real nigga, And when I say real nigga, I don't mean shooting, killing, none of that. You don't have no insecurities, like none of that shit. Like, you don't have that. Like, you don't, I don't feel like, you know, only a clown ass nigga feel like that. You know what I'm saying? Well, fuck that nigga, cause you know who the fuck you is. See, one thing for sure, I know you ain't beat more niggas ass than me. You ain't fight more than me. And I'm talking about superstars. So I can go to you, cause I know I don't did much as you. I probably ain't had the same much money as a rapper had. You just like me. You ain't over me at all. I don't feel like that at all. So that's what niggas be getting fucked up at. You know what I'm saying? You feel like that in yourself, that a nigga think he over you. But if you know that you been putting it down and doing what the fuck you been doing, you ain't gonna feel like that. Cause I know I done been in crazy situations that a rapper never probably been in. So how the fuck is I'ma feel that you over top of me? No, nigga, I can go to you and say what's up, nigga. No, you're a real nigga, you can feel that. Say all that to fucking say. I wait for my nigga 106 apart, I make it to the house. And when the premiere come on, he ain't there.
What's your name?
Lufa.
He is ludicrous.
He's all
my dog.
So I'm like, what the fuck going on with this shit? That nigga ain't here. You know what I mean? I always wonder, you know what I'm saying, what happened? Because they say he was here to premiere his video. And I always wonder what the fuck happened, man.
Your shit's supposed to be aired on 106 and Pop. So you did make it to New York, right? When it's supposed to be aired.
Nah, I ain't make it to New York, man. I had got to the airport. And when I got to the airport, I realized that we ain't had no dope.
Okay.
You know what I'm saying? So you already know when you don't have that dope, it's like, I got to turn back around.
Mattered to me. As long as I could get high.
Inside an epidemic.
Problem. Thought to be seen.
It was heroin.
It was heroin from the very beginning. When I first hit it, I was in love with it.
You know, and I had my homeboy Worm with me. And I was like, man, just that. What had happened, like, the dope had failed in the cup. And I couldn't
so you
get
had
it.
Dope.
Yeah, and it fell in the crack.
Oh, wow.
So I had got a hammer and a screwdriver. I'm trying to bam it, you know what I'm saying? To like, I put holes all in the door and everything trying to get it. And then I couldn't get it out of there. So we were like, man, come on, we got to go back uptown.
Got the Magnolia to the bone. HotBoy Turk.
Going back uptown when traffic so bad. Right. I ain't know about making a flight, doing another connection.
Yeah.
Fuck around and miss the flight.
I don't understand the transit.
I didn't understand that I could have, like, say I'm going to catch another one. But even if that, I still was supposed to be there to air my video.
I'm Turkey Ho, cash money hot boy in a black Rover. Burn it up on fire, spin bins like dryers. Don't ride natural, ride 20 inch tires like I'm hot and hotter. No other way, not a black hole, a red hole. Gotta be straight.
Make no sense. So now, by me missing the flight, they mad. So I'm ducking them now. I came up with a whole, I don't know what I told them a lie, and why I was there, man, and they still out of town a couple days after that. You know, now I got killed. You know what I'm saying? We were supposed to be in New York. So that's why the song on Taking Back, I was supposed to be in New York when he got killed. You know what I'm saying? Take him back, turn me and Bruce. Right. Me and one now supposed to be in New York. I mean, I been in New York.
Nigga. Uptown Magnolia, get the gat, nigga. Snort a pot of bag, then we go jack, nigga. Chopper with a ski mad, me crab wearing a rat, nigga. Riding in the rock room. Just some young nigga thugging, homie, I remember. Them cold nights, we was strapped up. On them long flight, nigga, running from the law. I had dreams on being a star. Warning rat, did a bit, I never got caught. Yeah, I never got caught. Signed a deal with Cam Money, I went on tour. Dope habit got worse. Shooting up my arm, man, I swear that shit hurt. My nigga Worm got killed, that shit still hurt. Was supposed to be in New York when he got murked. Take him back, Turk.
Take
him back, Turk.
Take
him
back.
Take him back. Take him back, Turk.
We supposed to be in New York. I was supposed to be taking care of my business. But we would been out there taking care of my business. We fucking around, worrying about this dope. Come worrying, like, man, fuck that dope. You know, he was always like, push, you know. And I thought about the next day, I'm gonna be sick. Right. It ain't guaranteed we gonna find dope. As a, you know what I'm saying?
As a dope.
So, you know, yeah. I let my sickness speak for me, you feel me? And that's how that shit was, man.
So, did the video ever get premiered?
Yeah, but it didn't get that approach like bam, which the new that would have made it been on the top chart.
So how do you think
they basically just put it in rotation?
How do you think that affected your career? You think that had anything to do with it?
That affected me a lot because when you mess up them politics, man, people be like, man, he did this, you know, like, you know, how can we do something for him when he didn't do this little small thing? It's scratch my back, I scratch her. And it was a lot of stuff that I wasn't knowing, man. That was messing up, you know, a lot of stuff that I had going on. So,
stay with me now, don't lose me. January 2004, Turk got in a shootout with the Memphis SWAT team.
There's no story what these guys are rapping about.
They put in a secret.
The difference between sheer entertainment and
a young black man accused of shooting. They talked about a rapper.
It's this well-known rapper from New Orleans.
They came in my house unannounced.
And you bust at the fence.
I did what any other black man would have done.
They don't wanna
take me to goddamn it on. You know, without saying as much as you can say without, you know, on the incrimination side, like, what was the day like before the shit happened when you asked God to, you know, when he finally came through for your prayer? What was that morning like? I know you said it was in the morning time.
Yeah, basically, man, it was a regular day, you know. My girl, man, cooked like she always do, cooked some bacon, eggs, you know what I'm saying, toast, you know, sudden. Girly meal for a king, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
And my homeboy. So, you know, it was like a regular day. Every day I get up before I go out there and try to go get it. But I actually wasn't trying to go get it. I was actually trying to kick it. Okay. I was actually like my 2 days in. So, I was kind of like going through the withdrawals.
Ooh.
But I still was able to eat.
Okay.
So I wasn't fully going through it. You know what I'm saying? But, yeah, that's how I was, man. I was basically going through that stage, you know, trying to like get myself together, you feel me?
Okay. So when that goddamn door came in, boom, first thing come to your mind, robbery.
Of course, you know what I'm saying? If you a street dude, you know, instantly, man, that's gonna be the first instinct. Like, if the police coming, you expecting them to knock, da da da, the police, you know what I'm saying?
Open the door.
If they're to say that, yeah. Of course, I would have felt like they was coming, somebody snitched on me, or they was coming because I had the warrant from New Orleans, you know what I'm saying?
Probation violation.
But
yeah.
It wasn't none of that. It just was boom! And, you know what I'm saying, ski masks I seen, and doom, 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 you know what I'm saying? And after all the shots, that's when we realized it was the police. But even when the police came, you know, we thinking that the police had then got the robber, so, you know, but then we realized, like, how they were talking to us, like, nah, you fucked up, you know what I'm saying?
Wow.
So that shit just was like a dream, dog, you know? They called me out, made me, got my girl out first, then they called me out second, you know what I'm saying? By the time I got to him, they beat me like a Hebrew slave, or like, I wish Tupac was here to see you, and all kind of shit like that.
So how long was that process from like, when from you sitting right there in Memphis, going to, you know, the intake order, like, I know that was a painful, miserable, long process.
I went to the hospital because I actually didn't trust the police to ride in the car, so I act like I was fucked up, you know what I'm saying? Like, man, my neck hurt, bam, 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 so I noticed that if you say anything about your neck, they gotta put you on the ambulance, you know, because they can't detect if you're lying or not. So, bam, they send me to the hospital, bam, all the police coming there. They look like they were mad, dog. Wow. You know, like, you in the gang. You a blood. You a crip. You a vice lord. You did put that star on your arm, man, and all this extra shit. I'm going to put you by the GDs. I'm going to put you by, you know, and trying to intimidate me. I'm like, man, I ain't nothing. I thought I was being robbed.
So did
I'm
you knew you time. Was going to jail? You knew you were going to jail?
Yeah,
you
knew I knew you I was going to jail. I mean, shit, I had just had a shootout. With
I mean, did you know how serious it was at that time? Like,
nah,
you
just... shit felt like a dream. Right, I actually thought I was going to get a bomb.
Right, right. That's what I'm saying.
I thought I was
going
to be able to get out, right, fight the charge on the street. You know what I'm saying? But I didn't get no bond, and I had to stand there until I wind up going to trial.
So I know this probably something... This probably be something you probably don't want to talk about. I'm going to ask you anyway. If not, then it's cool. But when you was in that fucking closet, like, can you take me back to what, like, because you was in there when the bullets coming through, right? 52 bullets, right? Could you move? Could you duck? Could you put your hands up? Like, what?
Man, I don't know what I did, bro. Like, right. I just know that I didn't get hit,
right,
or grazed. You know, I don't know. It was God, dog. That's all I can say. It was God. Like, God is real. You know what I'm saying? A lot of people don't believe in miracles. You're looking at one right now. You know, I done been through a whole lot of situations. You know what I'm saying? But that one there really, like, made me get my mind right. And that's why you see a changed man today, because of that situation, you know?
See, you told me something that made a lot of sense one time. You said, you told me a while ago, you told me that you didn't stop using drugs on the street. You said, I didn't stop. You said, I could have used drugs every day if I wanted to. Locked up. But you chose to stop in jail. And that was the time when motherfuckers be like, I'm stressed out, man. I'm going to go ahead and get high, man. I don't give a fuck. You know what I mean? What was your willpower for you to stop getting high in jail? Like,
cause you know what I'm saying? I wanted to come home.
Okay.
So it was like, I couldn't do nothing because I was looking for God to bless me out of my situation.
Okay.
So I had so much faith in God that if I give you something that's righteous, you're going to give me something that's a reward, you know? And that's what wound up happening, dog.
Yeah, he say he stopped getting high in jail. Like, that's some strong shit. I don't think I would have been able to do that in jail. Like, when fucking you got everything, the whole fucking world on your shoulders, and you got a chance to escape out that motherfucker, and you like to get high, and you went without and stopped getting high. Yeah, that was some hell of a deal. I don't think I could have did that one. That let you know your mind, you on your way to your mind almost being right. I don't think I could have did that one. No, I don't think I could have did that one then.
I didn't like get into too much stuff. You know, I got into situations, but not too much. And I just had favor through my whole situations, you know what I'm saying? And came home 8 years, 8 months, 16 days later, man, you feel me? And this is what you see now.
And you've been home now working. 10 years.
10
and
years.
And you've been clean. And grinding. So for these guys out here, man, who's struggling with these drug habits and shit like that, like, what could you give them, like, to give them the, you know, any words of encouragement for them to...
I mean, I feel like everybody needs something sometimes, you know what I'm saying?
Okay.
When I came home, I had slipped up, you know, and I was messing with Percocets and stuff, you know, and I don't know what made me do it, but them perks are good. But they were too good, then they reminded me of the dope, bro. And I just had to kick it because I found myself, like, getting real, like, back to how I used to be. And I know that would have led up to me doing heroin.
Okay.
So, you know, I just say, you know what, man? Fuck this shit because I never shoot heroin and cocaine again. I never snort. I never do none of that. So, you know, today I drank. You know what I'm saying? Okay. I drank. And I feel like, you know what I'm saying, the drinking, that ain't no good thing to do, but I do it, you know what I'm saying? So I'm not going to say I'm all the way clean and out the way. But,
yeah,
you know what I'm saying, like, anybody, man, that done been through, like, what I've been through, bro, like, you know, I commend you if you staying completely, you know. But sometimes, you know, you want to feel good, man. It's so much stuff that be going on, and I choose to drink. You know what I'm saying? I don't consider myself as a alcoholic like that because how I drank, you know what I'm saying, in moderate ways. But, you know, it's all good, man. I feel like you could do something because it's all a medication. But it's just when we abuse it and we have to depend on this stuff and we start doing crazy stuff and we start thinking, you know, because all of it is medication.
All of
it's
all medication.
But I think we abuse it and we don't take it like the doctor prescribed.
That's when it
and
comes
that's
a
when
problem.
It becomes a problem right. And you know the habits kick in and we start doing things to get it. You feel me?
Yeah.
So you know, shout out to everybody that's recovering or going through it, bro, because I understand y'all, you know what I'm saying?
What we got going on? Rich Thuggin?
I Got Money Now, nigga. The album on the way. Man, big, big shout out to Kevin Hart. Kevin Hart gave me the biggest shout out, man. You know, like, he really co-signed my Drink Champ interview. Shout out to Noriega. Shout out to DJ EFN. The whole staff, man, because, you know, Drink Champ wasn't supposed to happen for me, right? Because I was on my way to Miami and Nori was like, hold on, DJ EFN is on vacation. You sure you supposed to be, you know what I mean? So I was like, I kind of had got mad and I turned around and was coming back to Atlanta, you know? And then, you know, my people called my wife and was like, nah, they want you to do it Wednesday instead of doing it Tuesday. So, you know, I had to stay an extra day in Miami, which turned out to be good because I was able to spend time with my family. We went to Fangalicious. We went on the beach. You know, we did things that we wouldn't have been able to do because I would have went there and it was strictly working back. You know, so I look at that as it turned into a vacation, basically. You know what I'm saying?
Right.
So when I got there, man, to get my flowers from Nori and DJ EFN, man, and how they had my name on. So when he came out with them flowers, that was the biggest moment for me, bro. Like, I really, really appreciate it. Because I feel like a lot of people don't acknowledge the things that I have did in this game.
Right.
And for Nori, somebody of my peers, and Kevin Hart to acknowledge, DJ EFN to acknowledge, man, that shit made a lot of other people who was probably influenced by other people to start acknowledging.
Definitely.
And now, what's happening now, man? Everybody like, man, Turk, man, you this, you that, man. We fuck with you, da da da. And it's all good though. However you came back to me, man, I appreciate it. You know what I'm saying? However it happened. Album about to drop, I Got Money Now, in January. We about to drop the singles produced by Black and Mild. The same one who did that Kiki. Are you with me? Yeah, that down. You know, two singles on the way. You know what I'm saying? Shout out to everybody that ever did anything, man, and doing anything for me, man. My team, whole lot of Y&T shit. You know what I'm saying? Shout out to you, Sneak. One thing about you, dog, you a real nigga.
Oh,
you know what I'm saying, man? We trading wall stories. Y'all make sure y'all support the brand.
Yeah.
My dog done went through a whole lot, man. He done been through a lot. This nigga been supporting me, man, since the get-go. I'm talking about way back in the days. And this nigga doing his thing like he found him a something that gonna keep him from going to prison. Keep him on the street. You know what I'm saying? Being a family man and taking care of his business at the same time. I wish you all the success, bro. And anything that I can do, you know what I'm saying?
Right.
You know
that
I'm here to support, man. You feel me?
Yeah,
Trade Wall Stories, man.
16 days. Came home, you know what I'm saying, got his head on straight, you know what I'm saying, you know, got married, had his twins and shit, you know, he ain't looked back, he left the bullshit behind, you know what I'm saying, start doing good, that's what it is, you know what I'm saying, but shit.
Your attention.
Thank you, man.
I really wanna be all up in your head.
Yeah. This man Turk from the Hot Boys, from Cash Money, finally a free man. I got him on the line right here. What it do, Turk?
I won't look, won't be no bad. You just put that bottom up in your hand. I'll get you hot. I know you won't so well.
Say first, man, you know, get my family straight. That go without being said.
Say hey.
understand this. Niggas who are in the industry want to be real and want to continue to make niggas think they in the streets. But niggas who are in the streets who are real don't want niggas to think they in the streets. Nigga, I made it out there, motherfucker. You know what I'm saying? Y'all nigga be flogging, bro. Y'all tell a nigga to stay dangerous, nigga. I tell a nigga to stay out the motherfucking way, nigga. The fuck you want to stay dangerous for? Then when you go to feds, you telling on everybody, nigga. That shit fake, man. Y'all nigga got the wrong OG. And just cause a nigga got money don't mean he can tell you every fucking thing. You feel me? Don't let the money make you niggas dummies, man. Woo. Straight up, you feel me? This shit is for real, not a drill, man. You know? Nigga, I was born at night, not last night, nigga. This shit is gifted, not a motherfucking scripted, nigga. It ain't scripted, nigga. It's gifted, nigga.
Would you reach out to him to just go ahead and just happen? I feel like just one conversation would end all.
I'm not gonna reach out to like.
Did you see Rick Ross's response to the interview?
Now, hey, round.
Hold up.
Ooh. Yeah.
I got money now.
I got money now.
Ooh. Ooh. Turk said a lot of stuff, but Turk's shit is like Turk's episode is full of Easter eggs.
It's a lot.
You know what I mean by Easter eggs?
Yeah, oh. Yeah.
All right, Easter
bombs.
Eggs are where Easter eggs are hidden. Oh. You don't know where the fuck all the Easter eggs are.
You didn't know bling bling was bling block.
Yeah,
like man
gonna
be man.
But
we
you,
don't
but
know.
You watch it.
We don't know.
Like,
man man.
After you watch it, you
man
know,
man.
You don't have to like me anymore. I got money now. I don't care what you say about me anymore.
When you're up or when you're down, ain't no one around. When I ask niggas for help, I ain't hear sound. I started hustling, I got money now. I stack my money up and now I sit and pile. For the bag, I've been running miles. Used to walk around mad, now it's never smile. Love my dad, it was sad, but it been a while. Trial. Popping bottle like that shit is style. I go full throttle, you could hear the growl. Nigga, I'm from uptown. Tell him the truth, now I hate round.
Drop it, like, share, subscribe, comment also. HotBoy Turk, Druggin' and Thuggin'. But most important, make sure that you subscribe to this channel, man. Every week, I need it.
Telling the truth, not hating. Ain't no debating. Riding dirty with the 40, no registration. But I'm really just trying to give a motivation. But I up it like a puppy, no hesitation. When BG get free, that's a celebration. Only stand I'ma take is an ovation. More money I'ma keep making. My ice real, y'all can keep faking. I done came up, now they can't face me. A nigga gave my name up, but they couldn't break me. Now I'm rich and famous, them bitches wanna date me. They want that dick raw, payments on the baby.
You don't have to like me.
Okay.
Yeah, and they like to play the backseat. Okay. But when I first came home, I'd have been like, give me the little
$3,500. What the fuck is that, nigga?
Don't let the money turn you to a dummy. Don't let the money turn you to a dummy. Don't let the money turn you to a dummy. Don't let the money turn you to a dummy.
But I'm not hating. No, bro, I'm just being real, dawg. shit ain't always been like this. Get it understood, I got love for you niggas. But nigga, you can't do no anything to me. Let's get that understood. Yeah, I got big money honchos behind me now, you feel me? So it's even now, nigga can't say Turk about chasing a Turk.